I'm statistically in the minority, and I demand to be treated like I'm in the majority. You need to give up your power as the majority.
Sounds like rubbish, doesn't it? But to some of the crazies out there, this is what everyone in the majority is essentially somehow supposed to do. Well, the only way the majority actually gives up power is by no longer being in the majority. That's literally the only way. If you do it artificially, it only creates animosity, tension, hatred, resentment. It kind of sucks. Yes, we should make sure the majority doesn't screw over the minority. That's extremely important. That's crucial. But that's not the same thing as having the majority give up their power as the majority, or those with power to give up that power, which doesn't make sense to begin with unless you enact laws that force the issue, that make it harder for those in the majority in a number of areas as a measure to somehow make up for the disparities. I mean, if it's all about systems, and the systems are bad from the roots,
maybe we should just destroy the system altogether. And if it's about power and structures of power, let's completely destroy all power structures. I'm sure that virtue signaling will put food on the table when there's no more government.
I'm strongly beginning to believe that this may be why people with the whole
"you need to give up your power as the majority"
type of belief are often supportive of the idea of getting rid of borders altogether, and egg on the idea of having another population freely coming in and taking over the current majority.
It's all because the current majority is evil, imperialistic, and hates anyone who isn't in the majority because it's in the majority's nature to be that way.
To get rid of the leftover problems from this country's past, we need to tackle them one issue at a time, like police brutality, prisons, prejudice in institutions, etc. We can't just point and say, "majority bad, minority good," or "those with power bad, those without power good." It's idiotic. It doesn't matter how many professors declare this, it doesn't matter how many scholarly articles profess this, it doesn't matter how many intellectual-sounding phrases and studious narratives you exude, it doesn't matter how good you are at virtue signaling. When the argument is essentially that the majority, or those with power, are virtually always bad, and the minority, or those without power, are virtually always good, you've made everything binary, and there's no way for the demographic you think is bad to ever meet your standards. No matter how much people try to correct for the social inequalities and disparities, there would still be declarations of microaggressions. It's simply not possible to appease those who find microaggressions everywhere. People could literally be worshipping said demographic, and these people would still find some way to declare that people are being disrespectful. Once you get into the microaggressions territory, it's over. As a gay man, I could declare that there are microaggressions everywhere I go. I don't, because sensing microaggressions is a personal problem. It's certainly not something to expect anyone to appease. Even if the microaggressions were really truly genuine and could be proven, it's like an empath declaring that people stop having certain emotions, or someone who can read minds telling people to stop thinking about certain things. It's stupid all the way around. If people keep pushing these ridiculous narratives about the majority essentially needing to give up their power, and pushing the outrageous equality of outcome model, and if mainstream media is still unwilling to discuss how crazy these people have gotten, then Republicans may win again in the midterms, and Trump might be president a second term. The left still needs to have a much-needed wake-up call and flush or at least address the crazies. And yes, the right needs to do the same, but this particular video isn't focused on that. When it comes to media, let's hope for more shows like Roseanne.